4z minus 2z. So finally, minus and minus together, minus 4x minus 1, sorry, minus 4x minus x minus 5x, 8x minus 5x, 3x. Now, minus 3y minus 1y, minus 4y, 5y minus 4y is y. Okay? And finally, if you want, I'll just write this here so that you can check it later. This was 8x minus 5x. This is rough work. I'm just showing it to you. And this is 7z minus 6z. If you want, you may show that as a step. I'm just showing it as rough work. So plus z. This is your answer. Moving on, part 5. Part 5 of question 2. Add. Okay, I won't do another question on add. Time is falling short. I'll go to subtract and I'll do 4 part 5. Subtract 6a plus 3 from a cube minus 3a square plus 4a plus 1. Now, be careful with this question. Whenever you see questions like this, he's saying subtract this value from that value. That means you must put this value first. A cube minus 3a square plus 4a plus 1 minus 6a plus 3. Please have good practice of such questions. Okay? That subtract this value from that means that value must be taken first and then you subtract this. Moving on, a cube minus 3a square. These are not having any like terms there. No like terms. So they remain as they are. Plus 4a minus 6a, like terms. Plus 1 minus 3, like terms. Without variables are also like terms. So the final answer, a cube minus 3a square minus 2a minus 2. Is that okay? I wanted to do more questions with you, but I'll stop. We are running short of time. Also practice from Innovative Maths. Let me see. Concise Maths I have done from 11B. Questions 1, part 2 and 5. Question 2, part 2 and question 4. From Innovative Maths class 8, I would like you to practice by yourself 12 and 13. I was wanting to practice it, but time is up for me to stop. So I will stop. Please continue practicing your maths. And whenever you sit for these online classes, make sure you have your textbook and copy. And you are studying it as if you were in class and your teacher was face to face with you. And wherever you are not able to cope or it is happening too fast, you can replay it. You can rewind and play it again. And don't only do how much the teacher shows you on the online class. Try to go through all questions. I'm sure you will get an opportunity to clear your doubts through some other online channel that will be opened up sooner. Thank you. I will stop today. The next time we meet, I will continue chapter 11 going into chapter 12. Okay? Thank you. Also, one more thing, I have already taught you two topics before this. I have it in the file, percentage and its application, and exponents and powers. So when you return back to school, I can still give you a copy of whatever I taught. It will help. Thank you.